Two games left in the regular season. Meanwhile, the Canucks knock off the Chicago Blackhawks 3-1, out shooting the Hawks, out hitting the Hawks. Their power play 1-for-5, out power playing the Hawks. Hawks 0-for-2. Murph with the game's third star, according to Sportsnet's John Garrett. Frank Corrado.
Wow.
Don, quite a day for Frank Corrado. Found out he's getting called up to the Canucks yesterday. Debut this evening. Just walk us through your range of emotions starting from when you did get the call.
Yeah, I mean, it was unbelievable. I was a little more nervous when I actually got the call, you know. But, you know, once you get here and you start playing, it's just like any other game. And, you know, I was obviously very excited and real thankful for the opportunity.
You come to the morning skate, you're paired with Alex Edler, and you realize you're going to be in the top four playing top 4 minutes. Is that when you kind of have to say, okay, it's a hockey game, just go out and do what you've always done?
Oh, for sure. I mean, you know, at the end of the game, it is a hockey game, and, you know, the players are that much better here. So, you know, in a way, it makes your job a little easier, too. And, you know, playing with Eagle, you know, he was solid out there, and, you know, he's a really good player to play with.
What about the rise over the last couple of years from a fifth-round pick to the Subway Series to a final cut of the World Junior team, now playing your first NHL game? I mean, this has all happened fairly quickly, hasn't it?
I mean, yeah, it's the dream, right? So there's you know, there's not much you can say about it. You know, obviously it's a great feeling, and, you know, try to work real hard for it. So, you know, I go by it honestly, and, you know, anything we can do to help the team win, that's what I care about.
Parents got to watch this one on TV. Any plans for them to come out and try to catch a game live?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Congratulations on the day.
All right, thanks.
All right, Frank Corrado impresses in his National Hockey League debut. Don?
All right, Murph, thank you so much. Again, 3-1, the Canucks over Chicago. Back with Gary Volk as we talk about Yannick Hansen. This is a stat that I guess surprised me a little bit. He's been around for a while.
Yeah, his first career power play goal occurred in this game. I'm very surprised at that. He's come close to 15, 16, 17 goals. A lot of it's done shorthanded and even strength. He has had some power play time. The way he gets to the front of the net, I'm a little surprised. Look at Garrison's shot. Bang off. His shot so hard it goes off a couple people off his skate. And then like Johnny would do you a stick. It almost snapped it in half. Sure enough, it goes off of that for Dan Hamhuis, by the way, too, is 8 points in 10 games for him. Just feed it over to Garrison, an absolute bomb. And pretty surprised with Yannick Hansen. That's his
first
power play goal.
Now, the Canucks will hand out their awards on Thursday night, to their end of the season awards. I say Dan Hamhuis is a candidate for team MVP.
Wow.
Okay. That's just me.
Four goals on the year? Yeah, maybe.
Right.
Sure.
It's not all about goals.
Best defenseman, possibly. Well, if you're picking an MVP,
steady as can
goals
be.
Are fairly important in that stat. Maybe not for a defenseman.
And are you coaching hockey? You're saying stopping goals isn't important?
So that's why Corey Schneider should get it.
Okay, let's talk about, I'll tell you what's important in hockey, is getting officials out of the way when a goaltender's going for a shutout. Third period. Here's Chicago's goal.
Dan Corey Carcello. Schneider played great in this game. He's got the shutout going. And I heard you mention it. I heard you did.
Yeah.
Sure enough, right after this, he makes a big save. Puck goes behind the net. Linesman, get off the boards. Get off the boards, ref.
Yeah.
You know, if you're going to ring a puck around the boards, you have to get off. It's going to hit you. Where else was Cespedes supposed to go with this puck?
He
so
just kind of
frustrating. And you can see the guys looking at him and, you know, like, come on. Carcello scores that one. But here you go. You stop Patrick Kane. He had 6 shots in this game. You stop him. Number of great chances.
Yeah.
And that one goes in.
So the referee should have moved off the boards there instead of freezing. Yeah. All right. Bad moment for him. Otherwise, we didn't notice the referees
shame.
That
yes.
much, which
yeah.
is
actually,
a good
they
thing.
Were in a way a lot today. I noticed them quite a bit.